sense? Okay? So from here I pop down, legs, stop. Look at the back. Remember I told you when you punch your foot? Remember the back foot? Watch your back foot. See the extension of the body? The penetration of the punch? Does that make sense? Okay. I can back this. It's fine. But usually I just slam the punch with a finger tap. Alright, watch. This is called a split entry. And I'm going to show you this and then we're going to add the traps here. And then we'll work on the confidence calls. Alright, so watch. All I want you to do is keep this here. This represents the defense. Okay? When he throws the punch, you have to slip the punch. You have to have the boxer slip through. You can do it without the hand, or you can do it with the hand. Does that make sense? See, that would be a shot. See?
Round two. How about some Jun Fan trap? So this is what I want you to do. He's going to throw the jab at my face. I just want you to, you're just going to carry it over. But what you're going to do is, you're going to pave the way for the finger jab. The finger jab is going to come right through the center line. Now when he retracts this, that's when the trap is executed. So it goes one. See, there's the trap. And then I can just, go to E range, you want to go from there. Or you can work on compound trapping. So he goes the punch, I go one, two, now he crawls the center line. That's the win, and that's my next shot. That's sending an angle on without grounding. So, one, two, three. Oh, see, obviously you can add your other stuff into it. But right there.
So, watch. A good way to learn it is just a touch reference point. No, this is not how you're going to fight, unless you're in a movie called Enter the Dragon. We're just going to touch reference point. I pox out, and as soon as he blocks, I wedge. That's the part that I want you to get, because that wedge is so crucial when we talk about Jun Fan trapping, and even when we talk about trapping with the blade, which we're going to do a lot of that this weekend. The wedge, getting the wedge in on the lines in, and cutting those angles is very important, okay? So, I want you to learn, as soon as he touches, the wedge is off. See, most people, this is how they approach trapping. They block, then they grab, and they hit. Well, that sounds great, but this is the problem with that. If I go to grab and he moves the hand back, I've lost it. The wedge is like water on a duck. Watch. He moves the hand back, beautiful, it pops out. If he steps forward, beautiful, it pops out. It's a sensor. It gauges his movement.
So, because from here, I don't go back to go forward. I take his space. My forward motion should already be felt on his limb. In fact, if he was to drop his arm right now, that would just be the hit, and then I would just do my game. It's already being felt. It's like a pulled rubber band at its core about to pop, and you don't know when. It's an explosion. So, I'm here. Because, see, this symbolizes me coming forward, right? So, if I throw a finger jab, I'm not going to do this. I'm trying to hit his eye. Don't move. Let me hit the eye. Boom. Okay, now block. Oh. Think about that. Come on, man. Use common sense in your training, guys. Creativity, common sense, do your best things you can have in your arsenal, right? Okay, so, from here, it's already going forward. Puck saw, or puck dive, we'll keep it there. So from here, I go here, and I just hit. That's the first one I want you to do, very basic. It can be finger jab, it can be palm, it can be punch. Either one, it doesn't matter once you get the trap. Now, from here, it's already going. Again, if he moves his hand, when water is going down a stream and there's a big, huge rock, the water doesn't go, ooh, should I back up and reroute? Should I take left or right? It just does its job. Just do your job. Your job is to hit this dude. So, still reference point, right? So from here, I go here. As soon as he touches the secondary track, my goal next should be to hit. This is my shot. My goal is the next BLG. It's not to trap the hand. My goal is never to trap. This is why Jeet Kune trapping gets such a bad reputation. Because people don't understand it. Instructors don't understand how to teach it. So the population and the people watching this stuff is like, well, that would never work. Because people look at this as something we grab. I'm not grabbing it. I don't want to grab him. I want to hit him. So from here, I go here, I try to hit, but then there's the next shot. Okay, listen, I am trying to hit. If it fails, that's the next shot that I go to, and then add follow-ups. So, and then I hit a lop saw.
Yes, sir.
So I'm gonna box out, very basic, like old stuff. Box out.
going to parry it in. Okay? Now I can go low, hit, or I can go split entry on this. You say it? Okay? So the punch comes in, I go split entry on it. Okay? Now he's going to retract this weapon. So he goes one, and then there's the trap.
Okay.
Say it?
Yes, sir.
So split, and then there's the trap. Then there's the second one if I wanted it.
So the punch comes in. So I'm here. The first thing I want you to do is this. I want you to just slip this thing. You can put pressure here, but you see the finger tab is already there. So I go here, then there's the trap from there. If I hit, if I score, I don't trap. I don't. My concept is I hit his face. If I finger jab his eye, I'm not going to go, okay, where's the next trap? I'm going to go knock this guy's head off. That's the mentality you should have when you do this. Let's keep in mind, make your training reality based. Training is art, I get it. Fighting is the martial. But when you make your training focused on the martial aspect, then the martial becomes art. So, he throws the punch. He said, oh, here. Look, there it is again. See, I'm trying to hit the eye. He retreated. I didn't tell him to do that. He didn't know he was going to do that. My shot is, he may pull his arm back. Pull that. That's still the shot. So what I'm trying to bring out is this. Economy of motion. Fluidity. You don't go back to go forward. In fact, your only thing is to take a space. Go forward. Put as much pressure on this guy as you can until you can land heavy shots that neutralizes him.
This is what makes JKD such an effective street art, is that it's simple and it's direct. Everything is in straight alignment. The punch is here. If I lob side, the punch is back there. I'm not winding up. I'm not chambering. Everything is straightforward and progressive and explosive. Sure. So if I go one, boom, it's back there. I mean, that's my alignment. That's what I want to see. So one, two. Sure. See it? Now I'm ready to just tee off, double leg, whatever from there. Because sure. It kept me here in the pocket, so to speak. But what did it do to him?
Took him out
the pocket. Okay. See right here? Look. We're even. Yeah. Now we're not.
I said, now we're going to get a little creative with it, you see? So I faint, I kick it, the jab comes, and I split entry from there. I can still pull the box out, you see that? Now as I step, I slam this elbow right here, you see? Overhook, right? And I just take a knee. See, I move right into position here, and I just put the log on from here. That's where I want you to end with it.
Alright?
You guys got it? Okay, I can also do the low shot. So I go one, two, three, see? And I move that line, I may punch again. I drop the knee, control the face.
Yes, sir.
This hits from the way in if I wanted it to, you see? And now I just twist. Okay? My goal isn't to trap, my goal is to hit. But if I go to hit him and he puts up a head, I have to trap it so that I can go back to hit him. I don't stay there thinking I'm gonna go. But that's not how it's gonna happen. But they think it is. But yet they'll do eight combinations on the tie pads, and they think they're going to pull that off the street line. Or they'll get on the ground and they'll do multiple arm bar rolls, and if they go hit multiple arm bars, they'll look out. You know, it's repetition. Okay? It's Michael Jordan at the free throw line all night long. He doesn't just do free throws in a match or in a game, but that dude used to, his work ethic. And so I go one, and as soon as it does here, I'm going to hit this back fist in that. That's all I want you to do. And then that will be follow-up shot. But right now, I want you to do my 10 times pass over. That is nice. One more time. Watch. Check out here. Look at that surface. Watch what my arm does. See? Don't move. This is what I'm trying to do. Or this, really. In reality, that's what it would be. But as soon as he touches it, it gives way. It gives way. Making sense?
Sure.
Okay. You have to learn to go in and out of range without a thought process. So the formula is simple. I puck for cross, and then there's the kick on the second one. Does that make sense? Very simple. Watch. So I puck, I'm going to hit the eye. This moves his head back. The cross, he'll never see. You guys follow? So I found a boundary. And you higher ranks, you can find, you can seek the boundary here too. You can. There's other ways. We're not going to be able to get into it in this session. But the obstacle. First trap, second trap. I go into the boxing range. Now look, the pick is here. I heel pick him, and we elbow or forearm the top of the knee. I keep this. I grab. Look, now watch from this hand. Boom! There's the first shot. So I keep this. I get in time to post. I hook it.
Over. So you guys, let's say that the uniform wasn't a karate guy. Now you go over. Did you follow me? So like if I throw a punch here and he uniform blocks it, now I can go over and hit. But if he punches and he does it right, see there's nothing for me to grab if I go over, so now I have to expend that extra distance and I lose that economy of motion. So see it's easier just to go underneath it slowly. So just grab it. As soon as I feel, imagine you get like a water downstream and there's a rock. The water doesn't go, I'll go this way. Goes around it, right? So as soon as I feel that, that's how I look faster than I am. Okay, now watch. Look up. It's gone, man. The punch is gone. It's like a rubber band that's just ready to pop. That's the kind of emotion. That's why I look faster than I am. You follow me?
The next thing I want you to work on is the wedge. Compound trapping, handling the second limb. A lot of people, when they hit, they grab this hand and then they pull and they hit again. Well, the problem with that is, if I go to grab that limb and he moves it away, I've lost it. What I'm trying to do is hit. If that limb's not there, just move it a little bit, it's beautiful. He gets hit, okay? But also, it gauges me. If he advances, then I can pull or lops out. If he retreats, then I can box out. Do you follow me? So as soon as you feel that, see, there's the shot from a different angle. The wedge goes in first. There's the shot. One time. There's the shot. There's the shot. Any questions?
Then he does a pot luck.
I didn't get to the lock. So that you raised that?
No,
it's
shut
down. Oh, yeah.
And then he actually gets the lock out.
Hand position.
See, so I hit low, back this high. See? Work basic. I hit low, but he blocks. Same hand. So the 1-2, and then I just go back to the high shot. Those are your basics that I want you to get right now. We'll move on. Give me that? So, super slow again. Run for the point, 1-for-1. Okay. Now he enters with the punch, which is blocked. So I enter with the punch, which is blocked. And then I go through it. Okay? Third one is the beating toward a little punch. Okay? And the fourth one is beating toward hada or low yes. So, oh yes. So it's hada or low yes. But he just goes. See? So I go here. I go. Take it and just go with it right back to it. Can we get that fourth? Yeah. All right. See.
When I do this shot, the wedge is the eye shot. But if I run into something, that would be the next hit, obviously.
What I'm going to do is split entry. He goes in, I go, see, there's the hit. So what did I do here? This parries, it's just like a boxer slip, except we hit. That makes sense. So you go one. See it? Now, when he retracts this, I don't want it to come back, so what do I do? There's the track. And then I go right back to what we did.
So, in other words, I don't do this. I don't go, I'm gonna do this. I don't go here, pull and hit, let go of this. Now I'm back in a fight. In reality, I'd grab his jacket and just, that's the reality of trapping. This is tough. In old school boxing, old school pugilists, they used to use the term chancery. It's an old turn of the century pugilist turn. And what this means is holding and hitting. They would hold anything because everything went. There's nothing was barred back then. Does that make sense? So I wedge, I keep it until I trap and hit him again. Does that make sense? The Japanese and Korean way of thinking is that these knuckles are the strongest. They're absolutely correct. But what tends to happen, if you don't condition this, is that to hit with these two knuckles, you have to do what to your wrist? Break wrist alignment. This is not how we walk. When I shake hands with somebody, I don't do this. I go, now watch the fist. This is the most natural, and in my opinion, the strongest way that the wrist gets. This is not new to Jeet Kune Do. Jack Dempsey talked about the three knuckle punch in his book that he wrote in 1920. You can find it online. He talked about the three knuckle punch formed a triangle, and it locked the wrist into position, and then this formed the power line. So my rule of thumb is whenever I hit the bowling ball, three knuckle punch, vertical fist. Anything else in the body, I turn it over and I drill two knuckles. Whenever I hit, I was known for many years punching six boards. I did it regularly. And I did it because everybody in my, growing up in Taekwondo were breaking their hands on the wood. Nobody was getting over four punches when I was growing up. They were steadying way back here and going, well, where's your four, if the board's here, where's your four stopping? Here. Okay. But when I get behind him and I punch with a vertical fist, I go through the roof. I was regularly breaking six. He used to tell me, if you didn't quit, you can pay for it. Now I have carpal tunnel and arthritis at both ends. But regularly I was punching through 6 pieces of wood with a vertical fist. And so I've tested the strength of this thing. So when you punch, see, when you're in this range, this is more conducive to this. Am I making sense? If I'm here, this is fine. You're here, you're not going to be able to do that. So the trapping range, you stretch short range power. Does that make sense? Yeah. So watch. I wedge, lop style, or which is a pull and hit, slap and hit. Wedge, pull and hit, slap and hit. Wedge. This is called Han style. Jong style, Giyu style. I don't care which ones you do. Sometimes I turn that over, that's fine. Sometimes I try to get the eye, that's fine. Sometimes I gotta force the jaw to foul into it, and that's fine too. Does that make sense? His body is gonna tell you how to arm land. Alright, so I wedge, pulling it, slapping it. Say that to yourself. Wedge, pulling it, slapping it. Wedge, pull, slap.
You know, our goal isn't to trap you. I don't care about that. My goal is to shake your brain. And I was a boxer for 20 years, literally hundreds and hundreds and hundreds of street fights. This guy's probably seen me himself in 60 or 70 or 80. He worked for my security team for 6 years. But if people want the secret to win 100% of the time is to shake his brain. Put blunt force trauma on this guy till he is neutralized and you can get the hell out of there or put him down. And that's it. There's no other secrets to this. You hit him till he doesn't, till he quits moving. Okay, that's the reality of this. So our job is to hit that head, or to hit that eye. If I get that good eye shot, then I can hammer something a lot heavier. So the first part of this is I touch every point. The key to make me look faster than I am, I've deceived people for many years. I've always been considered the fastest guy on the block. There's no way a guy 245 pounds is as quick as I am with just speed alone. My dad was fast, he had fast twitch muscle, yeah, but I'm a big boy. The key is economy of motion and relaxation. In other words, I don't go back to go forward. That's what most people do right here. It's always forward with me, always. This right here, it's always forward. Does that make sense at all? That's what makes me look quick, because I'm not going back, I'm going forward.